Hello, people. I am Jabby Kuwait, joined by Char Kirk.
Hello.
And we are looking at the trailer to Saving Chintu. This is a request from Edward Sonnenblick, who is in a lot of Indian films that you have probably watched, such as Kesari, Veera Di Wedding, and
Manikarnika,
Bo's Dead or Alive, Inside Edge, the TV series, Kapoor and Sons. He's been in a lot of stuff, and he reached out to me because I would often comment on how the performance of the white actors in the Indian films was interesting, to say the least, and he just wanted to have a chat with me. We tried to do an interview, but the internet that day failed, and we reconvened. We decided to do it on another day, which is still TBD. That failed interview took place about a year and a half ago. So we just haven't done the follow-up interview yet. About the time we were going to do it, Corona happened, and that shouldn't have affected it because everything's on the internet anyway, but that is what slowed things down considerably. And he's also in RRR, for those of you who are excited about that.
Very cool.
So he's in a lot of stuff, and he, you know, directly asked me to look at his trailer. It was a short film, I believe, that he helped produce called Saving Chintu. And so here we are, we're gonna look at it.
You know about the boy?
Yes, we
know about the boy.
No papers.
Real.
It's been 2 years. My father's been my grandfather.
And where's your grandfather?
My grandfather is with my great-grandfather, and my great-grandfather is with his father. They love each other a lot.
You didn't get very far?
No, I didn't. I just wasn't clear enough in the head.
And this couldn't wait until morning?
No. Ollie seems pretty upset.
Yeah.
You should want to do it with Ollie.
I do want to. But I can't. Why can't you both see that I've done nothing wrong?
I want to say, okay, before I watched the trailer, I did actually look up the short film and read the synopsis, and I was like, oh wow, that's a really interesting story. It's super interesting, it sounds very compelling. It sounds like the type of thing that I would love to watch. Didn't Edward say that this got accepted into like
festivals and whatnot?
Festivals, yeah, like for the Oscars.
I think it was garnering recognition from the festivals, if I'm mistaken.
Yeah. And so like I can totally see this being a festival darling. I didn't really get very clearly a lot of the things that I saw in the synopsis. Like, if you blink, you'll miss that the bus says HIV.
No, I saw it. I think I misspoke earlier when I said he produced, because it doesn't show a producer credit for him. I'm guessing he's just in the movie.
Yeah, but it's like, it's a really interesting and moving story. An American Indian gay couple travels to India to adopt a child living with HIV in an orphanage. Will the couple be able to cope up with the cultural challenges? And I guess you do kind of see that, but I kind of wanted the trailer to show, a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that makes sense. It's like, I want to be...
Any more and you're watching the whole short film with it.
Well, yeah, probably. Maybe that's why. Maybe that's why they can't show so much more, but I guess I wanted to see something that was a bit more of a dramatic moment in there to be like, ooh, now I'm hooked, now I want to see this. But you're right, it is a short film, so if they show any more, then maybe it's just too much.
Adil Hussein is in this. He was in, I believe, English Vinglish.
Oh yes, I thought I recognized him.
I got his IMDb open. He was in Life of Pi. He was in English Vinglish and Hotel Salvation. I don't know that one. Good News. He was in Good News as Dr. Anand Joshi.
Yeah, I mean, they've got a really good cast here and a very compelling story.
He was also in Kabir Singh. In 2019, he was a very busy guy.
Yeah.
I'm like scrolling through his credits.
And Delhi Crime. Just won at the International Emmys.
Yes, he's a busy dude.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't stop moving. He's like a shark. Just constantly working.
Keep working.
In any case, Edward Sonnenblick was playing the American counterpart to the gay couple.
Yeah.
And they are adopting this child. I didn't get that from the trailer.
Well, that's the thing.
Yeah.
Because I didn't understand. At first I was like, okay, I know what this is. It's a gay couple and they're trying to adopt this child. But then there was this woman and I'm like, wait, is his boyfriend, his partner pretending to be married to this woman?
That's what I got from
that. Or is he really married to this woman?
That's what I got, that he was trying to trick the orphanage.
Yeah. I guess that is the cultural challenge there, because like
they wouldn't have accepted it if it was the gay couple was trying to adopt the child.
Yeah.
And so they he was trying to go in disguised as a straight man, and I think it blew up in his face.
Probably that's what it was. But you would think that like being an orphanage in India with maybe a lot of kids, and if you see a good couple and they have the means to take care of the child regardless of their sexual orientation, wouldn't it just be better off for the child to go with them if they're willing to?
Well, that's the point, right?
Yeah.
I mean, the point is that the bigotry against gay couples is so strong that even a gay couple willing to receive this child who has HIV will be rejected based solely on the fact that they have a different sexual orientation than the norm, or what is widely accepted, you know, despite what the laws say. Yeah, I mean, I can imagine how crazy that would be. Obviously, like, that's not something that is familiar, because over here, the laws have greatly changed where gay couples can adopt with relative ease, at least compared to what it was 20 years ago.
Right.
So, I mean, I guess as a kid, I can sort of relate to it in that that was unheard of before, but now it's more common that you'll see, you know, especially two dudes, like, they have to adopt. Neither one of them can make a baby.
That's true.
Right?
Yeah.
Whereas with a lesbian couple, you know, one can do in vitro. And so adoption is really the most practical means of getting a child for a gay couple. To me, it seems horrible that two potential parents, two people who are ready and willing to be loving towards a child, even one that they know from the outset is going to have years of struggle ahead of them.
I don't know, like, how much now, because it feels like...
Well, there's a specific reason why in this story they said the kid has HIV. That, like, that is a specific idea. I don't imagine that this kid has access to that medicine that you're thinking about. Maybe he would if he went with this couple.
Well, yeah, exactly. But like, they can offer him a good life and with the correct cocktail of drugs and stuff, right. He can probably have like...
But the fact of the matter is, anyone trying to adopt a child is not looking to, generally, to adopt a child with HIV.
Correct, yes.
So they're willing to.
Yeah.
Let them.
Which is amazing.
Just let them. What's the problem? They all they want to do is give love. That's very much part of the human condition, is just the interest, the desire and drive to give love. That's very much part of who we are. And you're going to deny two people because of their sexual orientation? That's crazy to me. It's very archaic. I'm guessing, based on the fact that this short film exists, based on the fact that it's getting attention, that this is a very real thing. I am not familiar with it. I haven't been looking this up. I haven't really had a dog in this fight. Since we're talking about it, for me personally, I don't feel like it's right to deny them. I would imagine there's another level of complexity there, though, with one of them being American.
Yeah.
I don't know how that factors in. Yeah, it's an interesting concept, interesting premise. The one-liner does a lot better job of selling the short than the short film's commercial.
Yes, so, I agree. I guess without like
watching it
and seeing all the footage, I don't know if I could offer any constructive notes as to how you could make a trailer for this that kind of hooks you in more than what it's doing right now. Maybe that's the whole thing. The whole selling point is the little synopsis here. Like, I'm already sold. You could just tell me that. I'd be like,
cool. I feel like this is an unfortunate circumstance where when you give away what the movie's about, it's like you know what the whole short film is, right?
Yeah.
But that's already being given away on the IMDb page. So you may as well give it away in the commercial, in the 90-second ad, because otherwise your audience may not have a reason to go and check this out. Mm-hmm. They don't know why they should watch it. I'm in agreement with you that the commercial that hasn't sold me. I'm sold on it because of bias, because I talked to Edward Sonnenblick, and also because the IMDb is a good one-liner. But if I was going off the commercial alone, I would have probably passed on it. When you're at a film festival, it's a little different, where you're just going through a lot of different things.
Yeah, you're watching a lot of things, and you're there to watch new things.
And you're probably going off that one-liner instead of a trailer, and so you're gonna watch it more likely. Outside of that circuit, then I would say you have to give away a little bit more in order to sell it, mm-hmm. unfortunately. So I get the feeling, though. I mean, this is a very common thing with anyone telling a story, whether you're a writer or a director. It's sort of this thing where you wanna keep the surprises to yourself, but unfortunately, you have to let some of that out in order to get people interested.
Yeah.
And people go, why do they give away everything in the trailer? That's why. Because they have to figure out a way to sell it to you.
This is the movie you're buying.
Yeah.
And then you go in and you're like, this is the movie I paid for.
Yeah. It's It's hard to get people interested and not give things away.
Yeah.
You know, unfortunately. But anyway, interesting premise nonetheless. And Tushar Tyagi is the director. He's also one of the writers alongside Sanyam Kumar and Corey Wright.
Okay. Oh, I wonder if that's based on their own story now.
It's entirely possible. But in any case, Corey Wright looks like an American writer.
Yes.
Who's worked on American stuff, like General Hospital. In any case, yeah, it seems like a bold story to create, you know, and put out there. So cool, kudos to them for that. You guys, thanks so much for hanging out. Hopefully you enjoyed that. And do let us know your feelings in the comments below. And if you know anything about this in real life, please share your stories. Check out Achar Kirk on the social media, as well as Edward Sonnenblick, if you can find him. Thanks so much for hanging out again. And check out our other reactions, reviews, short films, vlogs, and interviews. I'm Javi Kuwe. This is
Achar Kirk.
Peace out.